Hello, thank you very much. Welcome to our concert. My name is Jim Pisano, and I direct numerous jazz ensembles here, Jazz Ensemble 1, many jazz combos. I teach jazz improvisation and saxophone, classical saxophone, jazz saxophone, quartets, all kinds of things like that. In my spare time, I do this group, and this is called the Mid-Kansas Jazz Ensemble. The group has been in existence for actually almost, I believe, 47 years. It is an honor high school jazz ensemble that's auditioned in this area, and it's made up of players from around the region. We have players from Derby, all the USD 259 schools, but also Bueller and Newton. So we have a nice regional representation, and I've been doing this group for many years, let's just say that. So I took that over when it used to be here. So I'm glad it's back, and we enjoy playing for you. That was the Count Basie staple called Switchin' Time, written by Sammy Nestico, and it featured from Derby High School on Matt Cockrell on trombone. On Matt Cockrell, trombone. Give it up for him. On trombone, Matt Cockrell. And we're going to continue with something for a little bit more modern, and this is by Fred Sturm called Riverscape. Thank you very much. Let's give a round of applause for on guitar Will Fisher from Derby High School. From Newton High School on piano, Nick Bergman. And on alto saxophone from Wichita North, Aiden Kinch. Very excited to have this ensemble as part of the Wichita Jazz Invitational, Wichita Jazz Festival later on in the middle of 2024 in April. We are going to be hosting guest saxophonist Melissa Aldana, so you don't want to miss that. That's going to be April 19th at the Wichita Art Museum. In addition, this week is our jazz concert week at WSU, so come down to our new jazz lounge called Walker Jazz Lounge and hear some of the WSU Jazz Ensembles play tomorrow night. Wednesday night, Thursday night, and Thursday with Bobby Watson and Matt Wilson. So a lot of exciting jazz events planned here. Before we play our last number, I'd like to thank Dr. Tim Shade and the Wichita State University School of Music for inviting us to perform on this concert. Really means a lot to us. We've only had actually four rehearsals, so it's a great time for us to get a concert going in like that. So thank you so much. You've been a wonderful audience, and we're going to close out our portion of the program with a Horace Silver standard called The Jody Grind, arranged by John Clayton. And this is going to feature Kendall Chance from Derby, as well as Matthew Cockrell, again from Derby. Thank you very much, and have a great rest of the show. It's going to be wonderful.
thank you all. Checking 1, 2, there it is. Thank you all for your patience this evening, both with the house, but we wanted to make sure you got to hear all of the wonderful music going on. And of course, with the big set change, here we go. I like to tell everybody lovingly, I got my doctorate in chairs and stands, so that's why you saw me out here helping. Never too afraid to help move a chair and stand to help the show move faster. So there we go. But yeah, so thrilled that the Mid-Kansas Jazz Ensemble could join us tonight on this program. I think it's just a wonderful thing to get to sort of expose everything to sort of different musics. And so we had a saxophone quartet join us on our first concert, and then Mid-Kansas join us on this concert. You're in for a treat, I think, aside from the first three pieces that you got to hear. We have a wonderfully sort of eclectic program for you this evening. And while we're talking about programs, the little piece of paper that you have actually has a QR code on the back that I would draw your attention to that takes you to our digital program that has a lot of more information about all these pieces you're about to hear. But it also will show you a wonderful list of donors and patrons for us from the wonderful group of individuals entitled Music Associates. And we usually have a table. That's our fault. We will take the blame for that. Usually there's a table out by the door. And Joe Emery, who is one of our wonderful music associates, I believe is in the hall somewhere. I saw him. There he is. So if you just are so, I mean, just moved by what you're about to hear, that your wallet opens up and money just comes pouring out of it, you want to talk to Joe. Joe is the person you want to talk to, because he will tell you exactly how you can become a part of Music Associates. And I can tell you that we would not function the way we do here as a school of music without them. They're integral to what we do, whether it's providing scholarships or student trips or professional development opportunities for our students. It's very important. So please take a look at that program, and you can see what kind of impact you can make that way, but also so you can read those wonderful program notes. To start our second half of the program is a wonderful piece by Kataj Copley entitled Ayo. But more importantly, I don't get to lead these first two pieces. We have wonderful graduate students that get to work with us and our students, and I am so proud of the work that they've done. And so please welcome, for her conducting debut here at Wichita State University, Victoria Griffith, to lead us in Ayo.
Thank you.
Remember,
I said I don't get to conduct the first two, so I'm just here to introduce the next conductor.
Checking 1, 2. Still no microphone. Testing 1, 2 on the microphone. Great! This next piece, Letter from Sado, and actually the one that follows it, Boreas, the North Wind, are sort of explorations in sound and color, if you will. Jody Blackshaw has created a wonderful tapestry that you'll hear kind of at the beginning and the end of this next piece, built with aleatory, meaning chance music. So the musicians have little cells of notes, and they're sort of asked to interpret based upon sort of an emotion, or in this case, perhaps an imagery, to paint a picture of what's about to happen. And this is a wonderful, wonderful piece of music. And then I'll talk a little bit more about Boreas, but there's also those kind of elements in there as well. So the musicians, kind of like a jazz ensemble, get to improvise, which is kind of interesting with a band. It's not something we get to do very often. But I think this piece for Jody is wonderfully beautiful. Enjoy the build to the middle and some sort of extra musical sounds throughout. Please enjoy Letter from Sado.
Thank you.
So if you couldn't hear the sounds of the ocean with Letter from Sado with the ocean drum, that's what that was, really cool sounds there. You missed it. That was what we were trying to create. So might as well just go home now. No, I'm just kidding. So that was the whole, the idea at the very beginning is a wild sea, so very turbulent, and then the end sort of heaven's river. So it's the ocean or the water around the Isle Sado was what Jody was trying to paint. This next piece, Boreas, the North Wind. So Boreas is the Greek deity of wind. And that deity is enamored with an individual by the name of Orthia. He's trying to capture her with all of his might. And you might see two trombone players, one to my right, one to my left. They may be, perhaps, Boreas in this tale. Maybe. There might be a certain oboe player that stands up that is Orithia in this tale. And all in the beginning, it sounds oh so nice. The siren song from Orithia and Boreas singing to her and trying to get their attention, and I want to win them over. This is not a happy tale. It does not end well. Boreas loses. And you could figure that out by what happens with the music, but I'm going to spoiler alert you straight ahead. So it starts sort of calmly, and as Boreas gets more and more angry, the music boils and toils over, and it's full of lots of hits and crashes and asymmetrical meters and all this kinds of stuff, and it just sort of stops when he realizes he loses. So please enjoy Boreas, the North Wind.
Thank you.
This next piece is a little different. Until Morning Come was written after one of the many terrible tragedies that we and our young people have to endure today. Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School in Florida went through a pretty terrible event. And Andrew Boss is a composer that was closely affiliated with them. And the members of the band and the director there decided to have a concert after this horrific event. And they titled it Our Reply. Our Reply. And there's just one quote that sort of, I don't want to screw it up, that's why I grabbed my score. And it says, "This will be our reply to violence, to make music more intensely, more beautifully, and more devotedly than ever before." This is Until Morning Come.
Thank you.
don't know. I can end it right there and probably be good. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you for that, by the way. I'm trying out okay. Kids these days. They wait until the concert to give you what they really got. Goofballs. Yeah, beautiful music, but beautiful heart, right? To go there with that. Sorry, forgive me, but like, this tear's up here. Now for something completely different. We will end with something that's somewhat pagan, and a la Rite of Spring, you know, like incantation and dance, a wonderful sort of staple in the band literature. I figured it was a nice big bombastic ending. But thank you so much for being here, enduring our set changes, and a wonderful problem to have. There's so many of you that our box office was held up just a little bit, but hopefully you've enjoyed it. As I said, I would be moved to just hand over all of my money after that, I have to say. And I do, actually, to these kids. But please consider joining Music Associates. You're welcome to talk with me, or if you see Joe Emery on after the concert, please consider it. And continue to support live music. I cannot thank you enough for being here, supporting these students on stage, the Mid-Kansas Jazz Ensemble, and all the wonderful things that happen inside these walls and on this campus at Wichita State University. And then, of course, our finale, please enjoy Incantation and Dance.
Thank you.